像我也是之前也是很好奇啊，为什么他从把那个就是华尔街那么好的工作给辞掉，
华尔街很累的，
对，来办一个这样的就是语言学校哈，我也是通过好朋友来，就是现在我是家长，我是他的家长，
我觉得很重要。他因为他自己是哈佛的，然后他所有的你的公司的老师都是哈佛的，然后就是教这个学生啊怎么写这个 essay 是吧？
对，就是其实也那是对于就是申请大学的，但是他们学校好像是从很小就可以，
就是训练你的写作能力和你的这个思维方式。
我觉得我很有这个就是说发言权哈，因为我的两个孩子都是爱写作中心的这个学生，对，已经学了一年，他们很喜欢，真的很喜欢，就从他们开始创办开始，我们两个孩子就参加了，然后呢最喜就是我之前的初衷，
对对对对，
我儿子才10岁，还不到11岁，他已经开始写小说，一本他的小说是叫百慕大那个探险，他就很喜欢，因为小男孩嘛，喜欢探险。
哎呀，我女儿是一个，
对对对，
参与加入。
对他告诉我，他说妈妈，我要写一篇长篇小说，10万字的，他写10万字，现在已经写了3万多字，对，就是因为
就是因为
我都没想到，
陈老师这里
参加了他们的写作，
他这个写作的这个技巧和这个思辨的能力大大的提高，
对对，
因为我们吧，其实还是中国人的思维，我们接受的教育
说实话
也是中国，
对对对，因为对对，孩子的爸爸他也是高知识分子，但是在家里我们都只能辅导什么数学呀，什么这些理科，
我觉得，
但是唯独的，因为英语是我们的第二语言，我觉得这个写作和阅读我们没办法辅导，所以送到你们学校去是非常好的，非常感谢，
太好了。现在又有就是可以远程学习，
对对对对，啊，
也不像原来吧，只能是跑到这个地方去上课呀。你像他在纽约是吧，这么好的名师，他一般都不会，只会在一个地方嘛，所以你就他在纽约的话，有最好的资源，都是最好的老师，都是哈佛。哎，我觉得这一点很重要。
其实你知道为什么？其实一开始呢，我其实送两个孩子去他们学校去学习的初衷呢，不是说真的我们孩子将来能够考上哈，当然能考上更好，
就是说
考不上考不上，
你这样的，
我跟你说，对，是这样的。我觉得我的初衷是，我想让我们两个孩子呢，跟这么多优秀的，就是说年轻人去学习他们怎么样去。比如说通过上课学生学习他们的personality 啊，学习他们的怎么样跟人打交道呀，
哎，
怎么样就是说做一件事情那么认真呀，有计划呀，其实我是喜欢，我是希望我们的孩子学这个，不仅仅是学习。
等一下，我有一个问题，我女儿特别害羞，她很有才华的，害羞 shy， 她not outgoing， 所以她就是她要怎么样训练的 leadership。
How the leadership? Yeah. Oh, that's a great question.
Do you do training the leadership?
That's a great question. Well, we're writing school, so what I would say is this: our school's slogan is better writers make better thinkers. If it's not working in your head, it's not going to work on a piece of paper. So a lot of what we do is like argument building. We actually we would read books and we even would have debate about it. So everybody would be like, you have to talk, basically. And our classes are on average 5 kids. So in 5 kids, you have to talk. You can't hide.
在他们一个小班课，5个人在一起，小朋友必须要
Not one by one.
It's not one on one.
Small class.
It's small class because here's the other thing. The class is also, I would say, is fairly affordable. Like that's the other thing. Like that was something really important. When I started this school, I would say, like basically, I said, okay.You know what? I want to make sure good writing resources and, you know, like liberal arts, leadership, like speaking, these sort of, these skills are available to everybody. Not just the people who can pay $200 per hour. I've gotten offers to pay, like my hourly, like people would ask for my hourly of like $200. I don't do a single hourly because I would rather go and teach a class of just five of my students. And I'm not interested in the money. If I'm interested in the money, I stay on Wall Street.
Yes.
Okay. So I really wanted to make sure everybody has access to it, but it's not math, it's not science. You can't put 30, 40 kids in one classroom, right? I'm only having an average of like 5 to 8 kids. Last term, you know what my smallest kid size? My smallest kid size was 1. And I didn't even raise the price because that is my philosophy, that everybody should have access to this sort of quality education. And then you ask me, why do you not do college essays? College essays is so much money, right? Like, I mean, they would give you so much money, like $10,000, $20,000, $30,000 to work on your college essays. Why don't I do that? I don't do that because I used to do it for free. I used to volunteer when I was in hedge fund. I volunteer. I look at people's college essays, and I'll be honest, it's so bad. It's so like Campuchi, like it's so bad because Asian parents
focus on the foundation.
Exactly. So,
yeah, the reading and writing foundation.
Because Asian parents, they are like math and science, math and science, and then senior years, oh, we gotta do college essay. Oh my God, we gotta hire someone. Oh my God, I'm just gonna pay somebody to do it. That's like not how it works. Not how it works. And I look at it, I was like, this is so bad. You should have fixed this 10 years ago. So that's why I do starting from younger students. So that's my philosophy. You have to be well-rounded, and it's gonna help you not just with like your college essay, your application, everything, but to be a better leader, to be more outspoken, to be able to sit at a table with the two of you and have this conversation. When I was on Wall Street, I would do investor meetings with CEOs, COOs across Europe, across Asia. You have to go in there and you have to think very logically, and you have to then go to your boss and say, I think we should buy, hold, or sell this position, right? So that's a thinking issue. That's not just a writing issue. And that's what we try to
do. It's more important.
So that's sort of my philosophy of EWC.
其实去他们学校学习, 真正的就是让孩子爱上阅读和写作，
哎，我女儿绝对要报你这个学校，
真的，我觉得
她，哎，你看她这个讲话啊，你就能感觉到她这个能，而且她真的是，她原来，她真的是说她要改变这个世界，就像她原，就像
就是
How will you make the world change?
Yeah, that's better. So that's why I do what I do, and I'm so lucky to have the support of like the Houston community. 1/3 of my students are Houston.
Oh, we have a huge community.
Yeah.
And the Chinese parents, everybody are tiger parents, I think. Do you think so? Yeah. You're a tiger mom?
Yeah.
So, the other question I concern is the Harvard tuition fees. I heard if your family income on the 60,000 a year, the tuition would be free, right?
I have to be honest, I don't know about that. That would
give
that to the expert.
你是讲现在是吧？但是现在每年大学的涨是5%-10%的这样在增长。
不是
每一年，现在你讲的，现在其实进哈佛，就是学费哈，如果是没有奖学金，7-8万吧。7-8万一年。
你的家庭年收入在6万以下的人免学费。
但是你要具体的，那不是这样，其实要好好的做好规划啊。然后还有就是，其实因为你要小孩，比如说你们的小孩还有4-5年要进去，那4-5年以后这个学费就不是7-8万了，因为每一年都在涨 ，increase the tuition， 你要提早的要给孩子做好教育基金。
Yeah, I know that. 就是说我们自己家长要存一些钱，但是学生是不是看get some scholarship or
yeah, 或者 financial aid.
Financial aid, you need to pay back. But
no.
Scholarship is is a grant.
没有 financial aid 也是一种教学教
育补助，
教学。
中国人一般都是家长都帮你付完了。
对，
家长还没
有。还有一种是这样的，小孩子努力呢，可以得各种 scholarship。
所以我就是问啊，
对
scholarship。但是就是讲呢，你说的那个
提前的规划，
学生贷款是要还的。美国人一般
你讲的是贷款。亲爱的，你讲的是
financial，
no， 你讲的是小朋友是学生的 loan，
student loan，
呀，
你说的是 financial aid，
哎，是助学金，
这是助学金。我说
其实每一年有很多，就是说，其实高校政府里面补助很多的 financial aid， 因为很多的家长他不知道，哎，该怎么样去规划好，就很多的没有，对，很多人认为自己比如说收入十几万，他就申请不到了，其实不是的，其实收入。就是提前的做好规划呢。
我就知道说年收入六万以下，学生就免费。
那没有，看是各个不同的学校。以后也会改的，你只是说现在。
对，
以后呢，他还会就是因为学费不断的在增长，然后他的那个政府的补助。
但是像这种哈佛啊，这种耶鲁这种名校的话，他因为他的校友都是很有成就的，他们都捐很多钱给学校，所以学校他有很多奖学金。
只要孩子足够优秀，不会没有钱。
对，
不会
在美国不可能。
对，不会读不起的。对，
美国就是不管你是得到奖学金还是助学金。还是贷款，你都可以去读。
对，但还是有一点，就是说越早给孩子规划哈，做好教育基金的规划是越好的，越早。对，比如说打个比方，你小孩生下来14天，其实就可以给他做规划了，每天给他存2杯咖啡的钱。
但是
每天存2杯咖啡的钱，
我听说就是讲，如果你给孩子存了那种就是教育基金，
529，
你就不能得到 financial aid 了。
对，是这样的，的的确确，就给孩子存教育基金，你也一定要知道存在哪里。如果存在，
不能存在529。
对，如果存在529，因为529它的教育基金是很 limit， 就是说你将来孩子。你给他存的这笔钱就必须要用到他读书的上面。如果我的小孩，比如说我给他存了很多的529，但是我小孩真的很优秀，最后拿了个全奖，对，不需要学费全部全免了，那你这个529就不需要用了。但是这个你存的这一笔529，他只能用在教育基金教育方面。所以你如果用在比如说我孩子要给我孩子买一个car 啊，新的 car 或者 house down payment， no， 要有 penalty， yeah。 So 那如果呢，
有 penalty，
那现在就如果有其他比529更好的方式，就是比如说要这个有这个教育基金的这个性质的啊，这个人寿保险，对， life insurance， 就7702的这种这个金融产品，就又是免税，然后对孩子将来申请的助学金是没有影响的。对，你把钱存在这里是很合理的 hide， 很合理的隐藏，对，它不会影响我们孩子将来申请助学金 financial aid。如果529呢，你往529里面存1块钱，你的 financial aid 就会减掉1块钱。对，你就会少拿1块钱。
这个问题
对以后来
不是这么简单的，详细啊，
详细来咨询安吉拉王。
我想问一下晨曦，就是是不是从中学的时候开始就可以申请各种参加各种比赛来得到那种奖学金呢？
Yeah, it's so funny. My first competition I ever won was a writing competition.
Oh, really?
Yeah. It really goes all the way back. Yeah. And so yeah, the first competition was a writing competition, and then I won a lot of swimming competitions. No math competitions. No math competitions, but here's the thing. You have to get practically a perfect score on all of your math testing. Like, so when I went to high school, for example, and you look at like SAT, Math 2, whatever, those, I get the perfect score. So you still have to be good at everything, right? It's just that I wasn't like a math or science Olympiad level. I wasn't that. Mine really just came down to writing. So I won writing competitions when I was in middle school. And then I think I wonanother scholastic competition, a writing competition in middle school, and another two in high school, or something like that. Those are the main competitions that I would say I did. But to be honest, I wasn't even that focused on competitions. I, besides my swimming, I had a lot of awards, but it was mainly the leadership activities that I took.
Oh, you just wanted starting the experience. Things.
It's more about the experience, I would say. So I started a lot of things. Like I was one of the people who ran my school newspaper. I started another two newspapers. I would do a lot of teaching, like volunteer experience, but not just for anybody else. I would, let's say, like start my own organization to do it, right? So I did a lot of those experience, and that's better than, you know, just, let's say, being a, you know, an instructor for somebody else's nonprofit or whatever. Like you want, again, it goes back to the point, they want to find people who can make the world a better place, right? So if you're just going to be a follower, then are you really, like, if those,
it's
those
harder
people
to outstanding, be outstanding,
They want to find people who really care. So for example, there is this girl recently in my neighborhood who, in Saratoga Springs, who got into Harvard, I interviewed her, she got into Harvard, but what I loved about her was that she was a science person, but she didn't win Science Olympiad. She wasn't like the best science person in New York State or whatever. It wasn't that. She had a disease, or her mother, excuse me, her mother had a disease, and she was like, I want to spend my life helping research ALS. She wasn't the main researcher. She didn't have her name published anywhere, but she would call a bunch of universities, local universities, not Harvard, Yale, whatever, like University of Albany or whatever, call asking, hey, who's working on ALS there? Can I go help? Can I go help there? Can I go help there? And then for the nonprofit she started, she didn't say, oh, I need a nonprofit for college, so whatever. Her grandmother had a disability, and they couldn't afford to buy her a wheelchair. So she made her own wheelchair. She went to thrift shops, tried to find the pieces to create a wheelchair for her grandmother for only $10 as opposed to like thousands and thousands of dollars. And then other people was like, can we have that too? And that's how she created her nonprofit of making like wheelchairs using thrift shop like parts effectively, right? You can tell that person wanted to change the world. And when I say like, why do you want to go to Harvard? She doesn't say, because I want to make money, I want to go to a good school, whatever. She's like, because they have the funding to have the best ALS scientists and researchers, and I know that lab, and I want to join that lab. And I'm like, okay.
我现在有点听明白了，这个要上哈佛，还是要这个思想比较高尚。
那当然了，就是说没有，其实不管是上哈佛也好，还是申请就是大学，总之申请大学我知道的，因为马上我女儿秋天就是九年级读高中了哈，我就是也是在了解一下，就说他们在申请大学有十项。有 10 the field right， 你要去飞去填这些十项，比如说除了成绩，还有你什么运动啊、艺术，还有 leadership， 还有各种各样的，你要把它填满，还有你哪些获了哪些奖。所以说其实真正能够上名校的孩子还是一个全面发展，全面发展的一个就是
孩子。 It sounds crazy but that is actually the answer. It's how are you going to change the world.